We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
A very warm welcome to you all, whether you are here in person or watching us online. Today we celebrate the Feast of All Saints, giving thanks to God for those who have gone before us in the faith, and praying that we might follow their example of faithfulness. We also offer a very warm welcome to our deaf community this morning. As always, it's wonderful to have you with us. Welcome. I'm delighted to say that there is Cloister Club this morning, so if you would like to join those children's activities, please feel welcome to do so. They're currently gathered here, and they'll be leaving in a few moments after the Cloister Club prayer. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Rejoice, people of God, praise the Lord. Let us keep the feast in honour of all God's saints, in whose victory the angels rejoice and glorify the Son of God. We ask God's blessing on the children of our community. God of love,
passionate and strong, tender and careful, watch over us and hold us all the days of our life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Since we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, looking to Jesus in penitence and faith.
Almighty God, our
Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship, in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Grant us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those inexpressible joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this. When he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts give glory to the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. There come moments, I think, even amid all our cynicism and worldliness, maybe especially then, when there's something about the saints that bowls us over a little. I mean real saints. Saints as men and women who are made not out of plaster and platitude and moral perfection, but out of human flesh. Saints who have their rough edges and their blind spots like everyone else, but whose lives are transparent to something so extraordinary that every so often it stops us dead in our tracks. Not my words, but the late Frederick Buechner, American Presbyterian minister and theologian, writing in 1993. Saints, light bearers, life bearers, with their rough edges and blind spots. Although All Saints Day was on the 1st of November, we celebrate it this morning, having marked All Souls Day, its close companion in the liturgical calendar, last Thursday. Today, each of us gathered here sing joyfully to proclaim the wonderful revelation that all Christians, those here on earth, together with the great cloud of witnesses who have gone before us, are mysteriously bound together. And as we give time to contemplating what it means to belong to the body of Christ, the popular modern idea that there are no more than 6 degrees of separation between any two people on the planet takes on a wholly cosmic and mystical quality. By looking back over the history of today's celebration, if only for the briefest of moments, we may come to a deeper understanding of today's good news. The Feast of All Saints dates from the 4th century and for several centuries was held on the first Sunday after Pentecost. And although our brothers and sisters in the Eastern Orthodox Church still celebrate it in the springtime, here in the West, the November date became fixed in the 8th century when Pope Gregory III dedicated a chapel within St. Peter's Basilica to All Saints. Now ask almost anyone whether or not they have a faith the question, what is a saint? And as they reflect, they'll no doubt bring to mind people whose lives have been such an example of godly living that the Church confirms their holiness. Saints, if you will, with a capital S. Sainthood soaks very deep into our universal shared human experience. In our particular tradition, however, we have no means to approve a person's saintliness in the same way that our brothers and sisters in the Roman Catholic Church continue to do. The Church of England blends pre- and post-Reformation theology and practices in what some have called a rather untidy compromise. In fact, it is rather something of a wonderful God incidence that in this week just past of wonderful commemorations, it began with our remembering the great German Protestant reformer, Martin Luther, at the beginning of the week. And then on Friday, as if to bookend it, we commemorated Richard Hooker, whose thinking and writing on the church in the 16th century led to the later coining of the term Anglicanism. And if you read any of the New Testament scriptures, you will quickly notice, as Martin Luther did, that saint refers to all Christians. It isn't a category that's kept in reserve to describe the most virtuous or the most faithful among a Christian community. A saint, in that case, lowercase s, if you will, is someone who's been sanctified by baptism into our transformed life of faith in Jesus, our Saviour. And sanctification, saintliness, is really what our gospel reading is all about. In the Sermon on the Mount that we've just heard, Jesus sets out how we are to live in accordance with the values of the kingdom. The Beatitudes, the attitudes of being, are so well known to us, yet what do we make of them? For some Christians in the early Middle Ages, they were looked upon as councils of perfection, a series, if you will, of ascending spiritual practices to be reserved and followed by only a select number as a way of attaining perfection. But, as we know, even if spiritual perfection were possible to achieve, which it's not, such a path leads us to a two-tier Christianity, the best and the rest, as it were. So the Beatitudes aren't a list of entrance requirements for full membership into God's kingdom. Rather, I think that Jesus is telling us how God will always find us first, will always seek us out, will always uphold us once we've taken that first step of turning back to him. Sitting down in the hillside in the Judean countryside near the Sea of Galilee, talking to his disciples, Jesus wasn't trying to recruit some sort of group of spiritual superheroes, but rather declaring God's superabundance of his blessing to people just like you and me. People like you and me who realize that we can't do anything without God and become achingly aware of our total dependence upon him. People like you and me who get churned up when we've made mistakes and need the Lord's love above all else. People like a good friend of mine who told me recently, simply, plainly, and without any sense or hint of self-glorification, of her need for God's help so that she could be merciful towards those who had shown her little mercy. God's blessings upon us are not a future promise of saintliness, a kind of conditional reward for good behaviour, but rather they are the overflowing grace that enables us to see the saintliness in others and transforms us, often quietly in the background, largely out of our own awareness. St. Paul, in his letter of encouragement to the Ephesians, wrote, "I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses all knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God." May this be our prayer here to do today. One final thought. Outside the walls of this cathedral, can you remember when you last heard or said to someone yourself, "God bless you"? It's a kind of shorthand, of course. A longer hand version may go something like this. May God make you a person whose life is ripe to receive his blessing. The kind of person that Jesus speaks of in the Beatitudes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
As we rejoice with the communion of saints, Lord, hear us as we pray. We thank you for the saints who brought the message of salvation to these islands. May your church today reflect your glory and grow in holiness. With the goodly fellowship of the prophets, may we discern the signs of your kingdom in our midst. For Bishop Jackie, Bishop James,
and for the clergy and people of this diocese. Lord, in your mercy. In our day of thanksgiving, we offer our prayers and praise for the saints who have gone before us in this cathedral church, and for the rich inheritance we have received. With the glorious company of the apostles, may we in this generation proclaim the gospel afresh, so that all who come to this holy place may hear your word and know your love. Lord, in your mercy. Empower us by your Holy Spirit to follow the saints in the service of others, to defend the weak, speak for the powerless, and bring light to those in darkness. With the noble army of martyrs, may we be ready to suffer for the truth's sake. Lord, in your mercy. May the leaders of the nations act with unity and urgency to bring hope, justice, and peace to your world. In Gaza, in Israel, in Ukraine. We pray for the King, His Majesty's government, and for all members of Parliament at the start of a new session. Lord, in your mercy. Surround all who suffer with the light of your presence. Bind up the brokenhearted. Bring comfort to the poor, hungry, and homeless. To those who suffer as the result of war. And to all refugees and prisoners. Lord, comfort all who mourn or wait with the dying, those who are sick, and among them those in our order of service today. And all we know to be in trouble of any kind. Lord, in your mercy, we remember before you all who now rejoice with you in glory, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh. Those who have died recently, and among them Julia Matthews London, Jill Franklin, Jeremy Howell, Derek Not. Those whose year's mind is at this time, among them Andrew Baker, the people who have supported us and nurtured our faith, and all we have known and loved. Grant them refreshment, light, and peace. Lord, in your mercy. We thank you that in this Holy Eucharist we are united with you, with each other and with all the saints living and departed. Encouraged by their example, sustained by their fellowship, and in the hope of glory to which you call us, we pray, bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening, into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music. No fears nor hopes, but one equal possession. No ends nor beginnings, but one equal eternity in the habitations of thy glory and dominion. world without end. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
as the grain once scattered in the fields and the grapes once dispersed on the hillside are now united on this table in bread and wine. So, Lord, may your whole church soon be gathered together from the corners of the earth into your kingdom. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we give you thanks, most gracious God, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses and glorified in the assembly of your saints. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you. The white-robed army of martyrs praise you. We, your holy church, acclaim you. In communion with angels and archangels, and with all who served you on earth and worship you now in heaven, we raise our voice to proclaim your glory, forever praising you and singing. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again.
Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Peter, Saint Edward the Confessor, and all the saints, to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
With saints and martyrs through the ages, let us pray with confidence in the words our Saviour has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Crying, Alleluia, the Lord our God has entered into his kingdom.
Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Let us pray. Lord of heaven, in this Eucharist you have brought us near to an innumerable company of angels and to the spirits of the saints made perfect. As in this food of our earthly pilgrimage we have shared their fellowship, so may we come to share their joy in heaven, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Please sit for a moment. This is the time for the liturgical interpolation of the notices. Please remember that next Sunday's Remembrance Sunday and everything's going to start at a very different time. So please check carefully, otherwise you'll arrive too late or too early. And that will be a great sadness. There's the Come and See Breakfast next Saturday, the 11th. Invitation cards are available, so do bring a friend or two. Join us for a continental breakfast and a chat from 9 a.m. onwards. And this will be followed by the dedication of the Field of Remembrance at 10:50 and the Act of Remembrance. Next Sunday, the 12th, at 6:30 in the nave, our celebrant today, Professor Morwenna, Ludlow, will be interviewing one of her PhD students, James Gregory. That promises to be a fascinating encounter. Do please come and join us for that. One last thing to bring to your attention, really. There's a notice there about needing people to help with planning events, parties and social events. Please encourage with enthusiasm anyone who would like to know more about what's involved. Or if you yourself would like to help guide what happens in terms of our events, speak to members of the Community Committee during coffee. They will be hovering near the Golden Gates, waiting for the encounter with you. Thank you.
Thank you.
May God give to you and to all those whom you love his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.